Good morning, everybody, and welcome to Gyro at Home. This week, we're thinking about Pentecost, and Dave's going to talk to us a little bit later on about exactly what happened at Pentecost. Pentecost happened during the Jewish festival of Shavuot, the festival when Jews from all over the world would come to Jerusalem to celebrate together. But what were they celebrating? Well, they were celebrating the time God gave Moses the law, the Ten Commandments. Remember the Ten Commandments? How many of them can you name? It was also the harvest festival, the time they would bring offerings of the first fruit of the crops to God and decorate the houses with flowers. For any children listening, this week's messy bags will be full of food-related activities, lots of things for us to do, make and eat, and it might help us to think a little bit about Pentecost throughout the week. We're going to sing two songs now that I think we all know well, so feel free to turn the volume up and dance and move around.
Sing Hosanna to the King of Kings. Sing. Like journeys? How about nutshells? This is the journey of the early church in a 3.5 minute nutshell. Should we crack on? Jesus, he just climbed the heavenly escalators, leaving his followers on the hill back waiting. Not that kind of waiting. Waiting for Jesus' teammate. Up in the upper room, Holy Spirit arrives and boy does he make an entrance. First a loud wind. Not that kind of wind. Then the gang go multilingual. It's like they've swallowed Google Translate. There's Jews the world over hearing these locals celebrate God in their own lingo. Rumour has it they've been knocking back the Bucks fizz. But they haven't touched the stuff. To be fair, it is nasty. The team speak the good news in words and doing verbs. Pete preaches Jesus as saviour and Spirit as all-inclusive to all God's people. They set up a church kitty and open up food banks for the hungry. Everyone pitches in. Well, apart from these two charity cheats cooking the books. Naughty. People are prayed for and go from sick to formerly known as sick. Pete gives Jesus all the credit while doctors treat tumbleweeds. Hashtag rest fluid and plenty of gobble. With all the miracles, healings and talk of Jesus, local authorities and Jewish bigwigs are scared they're going to be yesterday's news. Pete and the team get locked up, then rescued by an angelic lockpicker. Wow, like a holy version of Prison Break there. Ed the logistics team gets tucked up by fake witnesses, throwing fake news, then non-fake rocks. With only persecution on the Jerusalem menu, church makes like a tree and gets out of there. It leaves. Church makes like a tree and leaves. Yeah, that's it. Then, major twist in the story. Saul, mob jacket holder of Steve Stoneman, who played hide-seek in prison with followers of Jesus and arch-nemesis of the church, swaps sides after a life-changing encounter with Jesus. P.S. Morgan must be gasping for an exclusive. Saul and the 12 figure they're on the same side. Yes, boys. Hashtag Team Selfie. Paul and Barney look after a church plant. Not that kind of church plant. Then good news goes global as Paul takes the Jesus message on tour times three, tour one, from Antioch to Asia Minor and back again. Tour two, tour one plus Greece. Tour three, copy and paste tour two, checking in with churches from previous tours. Lovely. On his trips, he has a Barney with Barney, hashtag hilarious, meets slave girls, entrepreneurs, tent makers and doctors, even shares the good news in Greece with Goodwill Hunting brainy types. How'd you like them apples? He sobs, saints along to the Ephesians and then to Jerusalem. He gets locked up, has a transfer request to Rome, he's shipwrecked off Malta, then sees out his last days bigging up Jesus and the house arrest. Nothing to write home about then. Be it journey or jail time, he pen pals to churches, laying out the good news, templates for church services and lays the smack down when they get diverted from the truth. Have that! He even keeps connecting with his apprentices, giving leadership lessons and moral support. As much as Paul, Pete, James, John, hey Jude, and who can forget the person who wrote Hebrews? Their name escapes me. And as early church grows, it doesn't just cross cultures and continents, but centuries too. Just like the Old Testament legends or New Testament team, peeps today get to be adopted into the very same family. So, if we click confirm friend request from Jesus, the Spirit moves in and we host a perfect tenant who guides us to look more like Jesus and connects us to the God Book, featuring letters, not just written convos from olden times, but must-have teachings for church today. Result! And as we come into land, Israel's journey from way back when, which kicked off with Abraham, then arrived through Jesus, is a journey we can join too. A journey following Jesus with Spirit as tour guide. And as for the ending, John gets a sneak peek of how the godly evil battle plays out. Spoiler alert, the battle's already won. Jesus returns, rescues God's people, and redeems the brokenness. Come on! Until then, the journey continues until full restoration is the final destination.
Hello, this is Dave. So, because today is Pentecost Sunday, we're thinking about Pentecost. This is the strange and wonderful thing that occurred that seemed to change the course of human history. Here's what the Bible says about it. When the day of Pentecost came, all the believers were gathered together in one place. Suddenly there was a noise from the sky which sounded like a strong wind blowing, and it filled the whole house they were sitting in. Then they saw what looked like tongues of fire which spread out and touched each person there, and they were filled with the Holy Spirit. We go on to read that they started speaking in other languages, they became bold and courageous in speaking about Jesus, and they started living a lifestyle like that of Jesus. It was indeed a momentous occasion, and Christians today still speak of a life-changing experience when God touches their lives in this way. This is nothing to do with religion, but has everything to do with spirituality. It has to do with a life lived by faith in God and deciding to commit to a way of life that reflects that of Jesus. If Jesus was the embodiment of God on earth, then the Holy Spirit is the Spirit of Jesus, or if you prefer, the Spirit of God living in us. In simple terms, the job of the Holy Spirit is to make us more like Jesus. This kind of spirituality touches every area of our life for good and gives us a real direction in where our life is going. The two songs we sang about before comment on this. Give me oil in my lamp, keep me burning, gives us the idea that this Spirit of God is an energy source for us and keeps us motivated. The other song was, I've got peace like a river, joy like a fountain, and love like an ocean. These talk about the effect God's Spirit has on us, where we become more like Jesus, who was full of love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control, all good things in their own right. I don't think that this kind of life is something to be avoided or be suspicious about. On the contrary, I think it's the kind of life we should all be clamouring for, a life that reflects the wonderful nature of Jesus and seeks to continue the work he began.
Let us pray together now. For the Spirit of peace that calms our mind and stills our life, we give you thanks. For the Spirit of love that touches hearts and reaches out, we give you thanks. For the Spirit of joy that lifts our soul and gives us faith, we give you thanks. For the Spirit of power, that gift of grace for us all, we give you thanks. Holy Spirit, guide us this week to become more like Jesus. Help us to show the fruits of who you are, full of love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Amen.